put all of the man hoping that he'd be able to his daughter, and she buried him a son. I like him a stranger, in a strange land. Generations pass, the Israelites obeying God's command. The fruitful land held alive with Nugris in Egypt. At the same time, Joseph's erstwhile service did the stealing for God. A new Pharaoh, a firm of Egypt's historical threat to Israel, finds little comfort in the immigrant nation, increasing prosperity and power. Subjects, the Israelites to slavery, hoping to undo them. He doesn't succeed in crushing their spirit, even as he makes their tasks more arduous. Hungry and frustrated, Pharaoh ultimately commands that all the Israelites, male children, be drawn to the Nile. This tactic proves unsuccessful through both Egyptian resistance and Israelite cleverness. A baby boy named Moses is born to the Israelite tribe of Levi. His mother builds a small papyrus ark, places the boy inside, and floats it down the Nile, where she hopes it will be discovered by a sympathetic Egyptian. His luck will drag it. Moses is claimed by Pharaoh's daughter, whose tender feelings shield him from death. So Moses goes to manhood in Pharaoh's palace, and is right in the enemy's bosom, as was bound to happen. Moses eventually runs afoul of Pharaoh, and is forced to flee the country. He soon finds a home among the Canaanites, and when Moses one day comes to the aid of some lovely maidens, he finds among them a wife as well, daughter to a Midian priest. Nature takes its course. Zipporah gives birth to a son, who Moses names Gershom, after the sojourner, refugee. In cases in Horace haven't caught the reference, Moses provides this clause: I am the rescuer, in a
we'll be right back.
the sun. I am in a strange land, in a strange land. Moses was content to dwell with the man, and he gave Moses his daughter, and she buried him a son. I acted in a strange way, in a strange man.
We'll be right back.